Hi everyone, welcome to this session dealing with evidence generation in Europe. I'm Nadia Quignot, Director for Decision Analytics and Real World Evidence at Certara. While looking at evidence generation, there are different existing data sources that can be used to conduct real world studies. The most known real world databases being probably the US claims. Within these real world databases, there is one which is emerging, the French National Administrative Health Data System, SNDS. I will go through its characteristics and its value for evidence generation in Europe, in particular in the context of market access during this presentation. After an overview of the SNDS and the key working practices to access it, I will go through its similarities and differences with other claims databases, highlight what could be its strengths and the opportunities for HTAs and market access, and finish with the stakeholder perspectives. The SNDS is a mix of different datasets. It includes the DCIR, the main national health insurance, including administrative information and primary care data, the PMSI for hospital data, and the CPDC database for causes of death from the in and outpatient sector. All these datasets are linked within a system SNDS. Coverage of more than 65 million people represents a huge amount of data and millions of claims. Until recently, French data were scattered among multiple databases, difficult to access, and linkage between them was not possible easily. Now, and since the two key laws regulating the access to SNDS and the governance from the Health Data Hub, the SNDS has been made accessible to private parties under the governance of the Health Data Hub. Basically, a two-stage authorization process is involved, with a scientific committee verifying the feasibility, relevance, and public health interests, and an assessment by the Data Protection Authority, CNIL, before the access to the data can be granted. Then, private parties can access the data through an authorized third party. How does SNDS compare with other claims databases? Before planning to use real-world data for evidence generation, the key escalating questions are, is data available? Is the available data easily accessible or is access restricted in some way? Is the available and accessible data appropriate for my research needs? While working with administrative claims data and after having framed the research questions, answering them involves appropriate knowledge and to be aware of the trends and the limitations of specific real-world data. Basically, key challenges fall into the following topics: representativeness and generalizability. Populations covered may bring inherent biases, for example, insured versus uninsured, health worker effect, types of insurance companies providing data, geographic coverage, etc. Coverage may also vary from primary care only, hospital care only, sometimes only part of the records of or a specific sickness funds only. Demographics are not always available. The same applies for some clinical outcomes. Coding issues are a well-known limitation of such real-world databases. Reimbursed claims may not be the actual health resource used. There can be incomplete data on mortality. Longitudinality can be limited. A patient moving from an insurance plan to another will be lost to follow. In terms of linking data from claims to other data, probabilistic linkage may not be as accurate, and there can be issues accessing the data. Some of these challenges mentioned can be addressed with SNDS, in particular in terms of representativeness and generalizability. Indeed, with a coverage of more than 65 million people accounting for more than 99% of the French population, representativeness is nearly total. Primary care, hospital data, and mortality data are linked, which allows to track all relevant records for a patient. There is still no data on waste, smoking status in SNDS, but algorithms can be developed for some variables. We can rely on direct prescriptions, diagnosis codes for comorbidities, etc. Some clinical data are still lacking as well, but with increased use of SNDS, more and more algorithms are being developed to approximate clinical information, or this can be sorted out with the direct linkage of SNDS data to relevant health records, for example, from a registry. Coding issues are inherent to health databases, so there are still potential coding issues with SNDS, but as a national database, there is some uniformity, so coding issues may not be as critical as with other databases. Due to the coverage and universality of the French system, reimbursed claims are actual and shared use. Mortality and causes of death are available for both in and out patients. Long-term follow-up is possible, with 10 years follow-up possible and nearly no loss to follow-up, excepted for immigration. Linkages between SNDS and health records are still possible through probabilistic approaches, but they can be direct as well. Data access is possible with a transparent and specific defined process in place. Key strengths of the SNDS can be summarized with 5 key items. As just mentioned, data linkage can be direct to other health records, such as registries, biobanks. Representation is nearly total, with a database covering nearly the entire French population instead of a subset. Follow-up time can be up to 10 years. People are not changing their health plans and the turnover is negligible. This may not be the case for other databases such as the US claim. Data access is through well-established procedures and can be granted to both public and private entities with the involvement of authorized third parties. The size of the database allows to conduct studies on very specific populations, such as those suffering from rare diseases. How SNDS data can be used for HTS and market access? First, evidence generation for value demonstration falls into 4 main topics: characterize disease, evaluate burden, characterize effect, and evaluate impact. They answer requirements of different nature: regulatory for HTA peers and strategic requirements. HTAs plays an important role in determining the added value of a given health technology over and above existing ones. They assess them from a clinical and economic perspectives, and that eventually facilitate decisions regarding the pricing, reimbursement, and access to patients. And the market access landscape in Europe is complex and different from country to country, with, for example, the qualification of the unmet need, clinical and economic burden, and benefit risk being key for France and Germany, while UK and NICE will mainly rely on cost effectiveness and budget impact. Obviously, there are also many similarities in how European HTAs typically address the different aspects when assessing health technology. In terms of the value of SNDS, it can help fulfilling most of the requirements, and it is perfectly suitable for gap analysis, identification and quantification of unmet needs, description of treatment patterns, and characterization of economic burden. Evidence generated using SNDS data obviously reflects clinical practice in France, per se, and per se is the most useful for the French market, but not only. Of course, if local evidence generation is always preferable, sometimes it is not possible. Hence, French data can be used to provide evidence not only for France, but also for other countries and markets. Indeed, key markets to generate evidence in Europe include EU5, and France is a key EU market. It has been highlighted that real-world evidence generated in one country impacts on the decision in other countries. This is also the case of pricing, both for early access initiatives and definitive prices. SNDS data has also been shown to be robust and suitable for economic modeling. This not only for the French market, but also for other markets that can rely on the comprehensiveness and robustness of the French data. The following case studies illustrate the strengths and opportunities of using SNDS data in this context of value generation. They also well illustrate the increasing use as well as the shift in the use of real-world evidence for different purposes, no more only for dossier preparation and economic evaluation, but at different drug development stages for description of treatment practice, standard of care, comparative effectiveness, characterization of the burden and the outcomes. First, this case study illustrates how those data can be used to describe patient subgroups as well as current clinical practice and treatment patterns, including for treatments that are not heavily used or even used off-label. Here, this study allowed to draw a comprehensive treatment patterns picture for patients with relapsed or refractory multiple myeloma, including for less frequent regimens and specific subgroups of patients. This well highlights the importance of subgroups and how real-world evidence can support in cases where thorough subgroup analysis of the RCT data is not possible. This second case study describes methods and key findings of a study conducted in a cohort of more than 160,000 of patients that were followed up for up to 5 years. The longitudinality of the database here allowed to assess reliability, long-term clinical outcomes with no or low sensory. Which exposure, which outcomes? This study allowed the evaluation of the impact of treatment exposure on long-term clinical outcomes, which could not be studied in trials and are typically assessed through surrogate endpoints, such as cholesterol levels. Algorithms were developed to compute exposure variables as lipid-lowering therapy adherence and intensity, and a key clinically relevant outcome, MACE, for major adverse cardiovascular event. Effectiveness is where life could hence be characterized. This third case study highlights how SNDS can be suitable to evaluating unmet need for a very specific population of patients, here those suffering from a very rare disease, transfusion-dependent beta thalassemia. Patients were identified through an algorithm using diagnosis code and procedure reimbursements, which was sensitive and specific enough to identify the selected cohort of patients of transfusion-dependent beta thalassemia patients, as highlighted with the comparison with the national registry numbers. This allowed to highlight unmet need and compute cost endpoints to be used in cost effectiveness and budget impact models. Here, the SNDS database was very well suited to answer this need for a rare disease. In terms of perspectives, such real-world data can be used in different contexts and for different stakeholders, finally allowing value demonstration and access. The implementation and linkages of even more datasets in the context of the French Health Data Hub, including SNDS data and data collected from medical devices or imaging, registries, clinical data, core data, health status tracking, will increase again the value of this database and the domain of application of such data-driven studies. To summarize, SNDS is probably the largest and most comprehensive healthcare data resource in Europe. It allows to conduct robust, reliable, and generalizable studies. And finally, with the upcoming new databases as per the Health Data Hub and initiatives involving machine learning technologies and artificial intelligence, this will certainly have a strong impact and benefit to all stakeholders in the healthcare ecosystem. Many thanks for your attention and have a nice day and the conference ahead.